First, a quick administrative announcement. Two TikTokers have cloned my account. They are now sending out messages to my followers asking for money. If you get such a message, that's not me. Please report them to TikTok. Can you know that you have eternal life? Can you know that you can't lose eternal life? Well, I'm going to give you the answers right up front. You can know that you have eternal life, and you can know that you can't lose eternal life. Now, there's a lot of well-meaning, educated people out there that teach you can lose your eternal life, lose your salvation. These people are tremendously blinded for two reasons, and I'll cover those two reasons later on in this video. I believe they're blinded for two important reasons. Well, first, how do you have eternal life? Eternal life is a free gift. Look at Romans 6:23. Now, Jesus gives us two simple verses. There's more than two, but I'm going to give you two that tell us how to have eternal life, how to have everlasting life. John 3:15, Jesus speaking, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. John 6:47, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath, now, immediate, everlasting life. Getting eternal life is easy. It's simple. You just put your faith, belief, trust in Jesus, him alone, and nothing else. For more information on that eternally important topic, please see video 152. Can you know that you have eternal life? Yes. It's not based on feeling. It's based on fact, what the Word of God says. 1 John 5:13, listen closely. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life. That ye may know that ye have eternal life. Yes, you can know that you have eternal life after you've believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Can you lose eternal life? Can you lose everlasting life? It is theologically impossible for a born-again person to lose their salvation, to lose eternal life before the rapture. I will give you three simple reasons why no born-again person can lose their eternal life. First reason, this is really simple. You can't lose everlasting life or eternal life because it is everlasting. Jesus told that us at John 6:47 that we have everlasting life if we believe on him. It's everlasting life. It's not probationary life. A probationary life would mean, well, if you commit a sin after you're saved, well, you lose it. No, it's not probationary. It's everlasting. It's everlasting. It's not conditional life. It's not limited life. It's not temporary life. But Jesus said we have everlasting life if we believe on him. Now, that's either true or Jesus Christ is a liar. Please look at videos 164 and 183 for more details on this subject. Now, the people who teach you can lose your salvation will not even pay any attention to what Jesus says in 647, and they will run to you, take you to a verse in the Bible, verses like Hebrews chapter 6, 4 through 6, and say, see, you can lose your salvation. Well, I have read 10 commentaries on Hebrews chapter 6, 4 through 6. Very difficult verses. Five well-meaning, educated people say you can lose your salvation. Five well-meaning, educated people say you can't lose your salvation. Those are opposite viewpoints. And here's the big point. Intelligent, educated people disagree. Somebody is wrong, aren't they? Well, what do we do? We default to Jesus. We listen to Jesus. Remember in John 6:47, he said we have everlasting life. So when I go to Hebrews chapter 6, 4 through 6, it can't mean we lose our salvation because we have everlasting life. What I've done is I've taken a simple direct verse like John 6:47. I use it to interpret a difficult set of verses like Hebrews 6:46. You can't lose your salvation because we have everlasting life. I did a video on Hebrews 6:4-6. It's video 181. Now, for the people, well-meaning, educated people who teach that you can lose everlasting life, that you can lose your salvation, here's what I believe about them. They are tremendously blinded for two primary reasons. Number one, they reject the Word of God. They reject simple, direct verses like John 6:47. They don't believe them. Also, because they don't believe direct, simple verses like that, they take the position that the Lord Jesus Christ is a liar. That's a double whammy. They reject the Word of God, and they take the position that Jesus Christ is a liar. I have no doubt that they are blinded. They are also blinded to these next two reasons I will give you, reasons why you can't lose your eternal life. Second reason you can't lose it. God forgives all sins of saved people. He went to the cross with our sins. He died and was buried and rose from the dead for our sins. All the sins of saved people are forgiven, including suicide. Titus 2:14 says this, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity. God forgives all sins of saved people. Take a look at the word all at Colossians 2:13 and 1 John 1:7. All sins of saved people are forgiven. Look at me. There is no sin that I could commit in the future that Jesus didn't die for. He died for all my sins. He forgives all my sins because I am saved. You can't lose your salvation. Please take a look at video 151 on that. That reason. Third reason you can't lose your salvation. I'm going to give it to you. Bottom line up front. Saved people get that new born-again spirit. That born-again spirit is joined to the Spirit of God to make one indwelling spirit. That indwelling spirit is sometimes called the inner man, sometimes the new man. We are one with God. God doesn't sin, and we don't sin. Join to God. If you can't sin, you can't lose your salvation. Now here's a key verse, 1 Corinthians 6:17. But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. Listen to 1 John 4:13 about this. We dwell in him and he in us. We dwell in him and he in us. 1 John 3:5 says in part, in him is no sin. So we're dwelling in Jesus. He's dwelling in us. We don't sin. If you can't sin, you can't lose your salvation. It's so simple. This makes 1 John 5:18 very understandable when it says, we know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not. We know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not. You can't sin. You can't lose your salvation. Look at video 147 and 185. Now, the problem for the Christian is the outer man, the flesh. We're still sinning in the outer man and the flesh. Overall, Christians are still sinners. But that inner man, that's the man that's going to go to heaven. He is sinless. You can't lose your salvation. Now, for the people who teach you can lose your salvation, I told you they were blinded. I explained why they were blinded. And they make some ridiculous statements about this subject. Here's the first one. A Christian may decide to walk away from Jesus. You can't walk away from Jesus. You're joined to Jesus, to one spirit. You can't walk away. Here's another ridiculous statement. Well, a Christian may decide to give back that free gift of eternal life. Jesus is eternal life. 1 John 5:11. Jesus is the gift of God of eternal life. Look at Romans 5:15. You can't give back the free gift. You are joined to the free gift. Those people are so blind because they have rejected what the Word of God says, and they make Jesus Christ a liar. Nothing can separate you from Jesus. Look at Romans 8:38, 39, and believe what it says. You can't even separate yourself from Jesus. Bottom line, we know that we have eternal life, 1 John 5:13. We know we can't lose it because, first reason, we have everlasting life. It's not probationary. Second reason, Jesus forgives all sins of saved people. Third reason, we have that sinless inner man. If you can't sin, you can't lose your salvation.